hope you have found out the poetic device.
Now that we have seen the third stanza, let us look at the rhyming scheme and verify whether the entire poem has the same poetic device for rhyming scheme. The 19th line, that is the beginning of your third stanza, ends with the word friend, and the next line ends with the word lend. So do you say that friend and lend rhyme with each other? So let us start naming them as A. And the next two lines ends with by and I. So we'll name them as B. Similarly, the next two lines have the ending words as light and night. So it is to be named as C. Let us look at the last three lines. Just like the first and second stanzas, here also we have 1, 2, 3. Three lines having rhyming words. Gay, say and away. So let us name them as D, B and B. Now we know that they have the same rhyming scheme for all the three stanzas. A, A, B, B, C, C, B, D and B. Can we call that the poem has the uniform rhyming scheme of A, A, B, B, C, C, D, D, D. Now we have four more lines of the poem remaining, which is like the conclusion for the poem. So for those lines, we are not going to consider this rhyming scheme. Shall we take a look at it, children? Yeah, like I told you, these are the last four lines of the poem, which conveys a very strong message to all of us from the poet. So here we are not going to look at the rhyming scheme to be included as a part of this poem. Okay. Thus ending, he hastily lifted the wicket. So the aunt had spoken saying that since you danced your summer days singing and happily just spending the time, similarly, why don't you just dance away the winter time also? So he says, after saying that, he just lifts the wicket, probably the door which covered the place where the aunt lived. So he lifts that place, lifts that wicket, and out of the door turned the poor little cricket. So what happens when the aunt opens the door? The cricket understands that he is not welcome there anymore. He just has to leave. So he comes out of the door. Folks call this a fable. Folks means generally people. Folks call this a fable. I warrant it true. So what Aesop says is, though it is called a story, but I say that this is true. Why? Some cricket have four legs and some have two. So here what the poet has done, he has said that this situation is not only for the crickets, but it holds good for humans also. That's the reason he has mentioned that there are crickets with two legs also. Read this line and try to understand the meaning. Read the line? Okay. Some cricket have four legs. Generally, when we see crickets, we know that they have four legs. But here the poet says, some have two. So, the crickets which have four legs are animals, and the cricket which he has said that have two legs are us, human beings. Aren't there many people who do not worry about future? They just live for today. They don't worry or think or plan anything for the future. So, the poet says, though people call it a tale, they may call it as a story, but he says that I can guarantee you that this is a real-time situation. In reality also, not just this ant and the cricket, there are many people in our real lives who do not bother about their future like the cricket, and there are also people who worry, who actually are concerned about their future. They plan for it and then they secure their future. So what is the moral conveyed through this poem? If you are very happy today, your future is not going to be so happy and bright. So to have a safe, secured and happy future, you need to struggle a little bit in present time. Okay, I'll read the last four lines and then we'll close this poem. Thus ending, he hastily lifted the wicket and out of the door turned the poor little cricket. Folks call this a fable, I warrant it true. Some cricket have four legs and some have two. Like I've been telling you from the beginning, this story is adapted from Aesop's fables. Read the poem completely for yourself, children. I had asked you to write the first lines of the poem based on what I had shown. First two stanzas you can write in your notebook and try to draw that ant and cricket from your textbook. I'll send you an image of the pages from your textbook for those who have not yet purchased your text. Okay, so do this writing and drawing work in your new notebook if you already have. If you don't have, just don't worry. You're always welcome to use your last year's English notebook. Okay, thank you children. I'll come back soon with another video for your class.